Hi everyone, welcome back to CAD CAM Course YouTube channel. Today in this FreeCAD Beginners video, we'll be creating this object using the Part Design Workbench. I'll be using this reference orthogonal sketch to grab my dimensions from for this object. If you have followed my previous videos, you will notice that first we will break down the complex solid into simple and easy steps. For this tutorial, I have broken down the process into 7 easy steps. We can create the model through this follow-along PDF. So I'll include a link to this if you'd like to download it and follow along. To begin, we'll go to Part Design Workbench in FreeCAD. Now I'll go ahead and select the Create Sketch tool. This will bring up 3 planes. And for this sketch, I'll be working on the front plane, which is the XZ plane. I'll go ahead and select it. Once the plane is selected, FreeCAD will switch to sketcher mode, where we can start drawing. Next, I'll grab this Create Polyline tool from the Sketcher toolbar. This tool allows us to create multiple connected lines in a single go. I'll start drawing from the origin, which is the center point of our plane, and begin creating the kind of rough outline of our shape. Oh, looks like construction geometry is turned on. Construction geometry is represented by these dashed lines and is only used as a reference. It won't be part of the final shape. To fix this, find the toggle button for construction geometry on the toolbar and click it to switch to normal geometry. All right, now I can continue sketching. As I draw, I'll make sure to constrain the lines properly. Whenever I draw a vertical or horizontal line, FreeCAD should automatically apply vertical and horizontal constraints. You can see these small constraint symbols appearing on the lines. Once the entire outline is complete, I'll right-click twice to exit the polyline tool. Now, to fix the first line, I'll right-click on this line I drew, then select toggle construction geometry to switch it to normal geometry. Okay, so you can see that the sketch is under constrained. So I will go ahead and select the dimension tool and key in the dimensions as per this drawing. Now I'll start applying the dimensions one by one. First, I'll click on this vertical line, then click to place the dimension. I'll type 40 millimeters and press enter. Next, I'll click on this horizontal line, then click to place the dimension. I'll type 20 millimeters and press enter. Now I'll do the same for the other vertical line, setting it to 20 millimeters. Finally, I'll set the last horizontal line to 40 millimeters. As soon as I enter the last dimension, you'll notice that the entire sketch turns green. This means the sketch is fully constrained. Now that our sketch is fully defined, I'll go ahead and click the close button to exit the Sketcher workbench and return to the Part Design workbench. So, the next step is to revolve this sketch to create our 3D shape. To do this, I'll go ahead and click on the revolution tool from the toolbar. Now, FreeCAD automatically selects an axis of rotation for the sketch. In this case, it has correctly chosen the vertical axis, which is exactly what we need. But if for some reason your axis isn't set correctly, select vertical sketch axis to fix it. Once everything looks good, I'll click OK. Great job. You've successfully completed step one. Now let's move on to the next step. All right, now that we have our base shape, let's move on to step two. Here we'll create a circular slot on its circumference. If we look at the reference sketch, we can see that this slot is actually a segment of a larger circle. From the sketch, we can notice that the center of this circle is located on the circumference of this imaginary circle of 94 millimeters diameter. Now in the Part Design workbench, rotate the model to view the bottom face. Click on this little cube up here to kind of change your view such that the bottom face is visible. Once the bottom face is visible, I'll click on it to select it. Next, I'll go to the toolbar and click on the Create Sketch tool. To make sure everything fits into view nicely, I'll click on the Fit All icon in the toolbar. Now we need to create a reference circle to position the slot. I'll select the Circle tool from the Sketching toolbar. Then I'll click on the Origin as the center and drag out a circle. Since this is just a reference, I'll right-click on the circle, go to toggle construction geometry, and you'll see that the circle turns into a dashed line. Now, select the dimension tool, click on the circle, and enter 94 millimeters as the diameter. Again, I'll select the circle tool. This time, instead of the origin, I'll click on the intersection point where the reference circle meets the x-axis. That's where the slot's center should be. I'll drag out a rough circle, then I'll use the dimension tool, click on the circle, and set its diameter to 30 millimeters. At this point, if you try to move the circle, you'll notice that the position of its center isn't fully locked down. To fix this, I'll select the center point of the circle and the origin, then click on the horizontal constraint button in the toolbar. Now the circle turns green, which means it's fully constrained. I'll close the sketch to exit the Sketcher workbench. Then I'll press zero on the keyboard to return to an isometric view, and again click fit all to adjust the view. Now I'll select the newly created sketch and go to the pocket tool. In the pocket parameters, I'll set the type to through all to cut completely through the object. Finally, I'll click OK, and circular slot is created. We've successfully created the first circular slot. Now let's move on to step three. Here we'll repeat this slot around the circumference to create a circular pattern with six instances. First, let's go to the model tree on the left-hand side. Here, I'll locate and click on the pocket operation, and this is the cut we just created in step two. Now we'll move to the toolbar and click on the polar pattern tool. Once the polar pattern settings open up, we need to make a few changes. I'll click inside the box and type 6 and press enter. The FreeCAD will now automatically distribute 6 identical slots evenly around the circumference. Everything looks good now. Great job. We've successfully completed step 3. Now let's move on to step 4. Now the step number 4 is to apply chamfers and fillets. So first select this edge and select the chamfer tool and change the size of the chamfer to 4 millimeters and click OK. Now navigate to the bottom face, select the bottom face, and select the fillet tool. Change the radius of the fillet to 5 millimeters and click OK. Bottom face is completed. Now, for this face, if you select the face and apply the fillet will also be applied to this middle edge. But the chamfer is not present in the middle portion. So cancel this operation and select the edges independently. If required, rotate the view to select all the edges on the top face. After selecting all the edges, click on the fillet tool and change the radius to 5 millimeters and click OK. Now press 0 to reorient to isometric view. Step 4 is now completed. Now in step 5, we'll create this blind hole at the center of our model. This hole will have a diameter of 10 millimeters and a depth of 25 millimeters. First, we need to define the hole's location. So let's select the top face of the model. Now I'll go up to the toolbar and click on the Create Sketch tool. This will take us into the Sketcher workbench. I'll click on the circle tool from the toolbar. Now I'll move the cursor to the origin and click once to set it as the center. Then I'll drag out a small circle and before clicking again to place it. Enter the dimension of 10 millimeters and press enter. As soon as I press enter, the circle turns green, meaning it is fully constrained. Now that our sketch is ready, I'll go ahead and close the sketch. Back in the Park Design Workbench, I'll select the pocket tool from the toolbar. A parameters panel appears. Here, I'll set the length of the hole to 25 millimeters. Once that's done, I'll click OK. And the hole is created. All right, step 5 is done, and now we're moving on to step 6. Here, we'll create this side hole. This hole has a diameter of 8 millimeters and is drilled from one side all the way to the center. First, we need to start a new sketch. So go to the toolbar and click on the Create Sketch tool. Now here, I'll choose the XZ plane, which is also called the front plane. Instead of creating a new plane from the side surface, we will utilize one of the primary planes that already exist. So go ahead and select XZ plane and hit OK. Now that we're in the Sketcher workbench, let's grab the circle tool from the toolbar. Move the cursor along the Z-axis, somewhere roughly here, and click to place the center. Then drag out to create a small circle and click again to place it. The circle isn't visible. That's because it's inside the solid model. So let's right-click to cancel the circle tool. Now, to make things easier, I'll click on this View Section tool in the toolbar. This will slice the model along our sketch plane, making the inside of the solid visible. This is just for viewing. When we disable the View Section tool, everything will return to normal. Now that we can see the circle, let's define its diameter. I'll select the Dimension tool, click on the circle, and enter 8 millimeters. The sketch is still under constrained, which means we've defined the size, but its position isn't fixed yet. From the reference drawing, we can see that this hole should be 30 millimeters above the base. So let's grab the Dimension tool again, select the center of the circle, select the origin point at the base, enter 30 millimeters, and press Enter. Now the sketch turns green, meaning it is fully constrained. We're done with the sketch, so let's close it. Back in the Part Design Workbench, I'll select the sketch we just created. Now I'll click on the Pocket tool in the toolbar. In the pocket parameters, set the type to through all. The hole isn't visible. That's because it drilled in the wrong direction. I'll just tick the reversed option. And now the hole is correctly drilled from the center towards the side. Congratulations, the model is successfully completed. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.